My name is Mekme Obasoge. I'm sitting here in the ancient city of Benin. Sitting next to me is my honorable chief, Omo Osaige, who takes a legacy, the Obadola Moyi of Benin Kingdom. Today, he's going to tell us the history of Ize Lokoko. Ize was a woman that sacrificed her life for the reconciliation of the Benin people. So, sir, what happened to Ize?
Ize Lokoko. Opoko Ize. A great woman who gave up her life for no personal gains, because she was not the mother of the crown prince. She didn't even have a child yet or the other. But she gave up her life so that the monarchy will be restored, sanctity will be restored, and the nation, the Benin Kingdom, the nation will be restored. Ide, as a young woman from birth, our culture is that when a baby girl is born into a decent family, men will go and to go and show their intention. The man called Ode, who later became Iyase Ode, went to signify intention of marrying the girl when she grows up. That is not a formal betrothal ceremony, but it is taken as the man in our local palace, Osunga Gayoko, we do things for the family of the girl until she grows into the age of marriage. Then, as she grew up into a very beautiful, well-cultured young lady. And then the royal family signified intention of marrying her. Of course, the best goes to the palace. The royal palace cannot stretch out a hand over anything. And another indigene, another person, a Benin person, will also be stretching his hand towards the same thing. It's an aberration of our culture. So, but when Oba Ewape got to know that Iyase Ode, Ode was already into it, he now, you know, pacified him, or rather he thought he pacified him with the title of Iyase, which is the highest title in the land that is supposed to be given to your closest friend. Because the title came from a situation of Iyona Sowa. That would be a story for another day. Ijona Sowa, that is what Iyase means. And the person has to be very, very close to the other. Then, Ode became the Iyase, but his mind never left that situation. He never removed his heart from the lady. And so, he started to plan insurgency against the palace, and that of course means against Benin. He said so many things against the palace, against the crown. Then it now happened that it fell within the period of time that Ewebunuza, the mother of the Oba, passed on to become an ancestor. As it was our culture, we will have people to escort such a personality to the other side. So, Iyase Ode took that as an opportunity to fight against the crown. He was able to get the chiefs, being the Yasser, the most powerful man, and he was rich. He got Ezomu, Olia, Esoma, all of them to his side. And then they swooped on the palace. On the day His Majesty went to Ikoka. Ikoka is a place close to Udo, the home, the birthplace of Ewebunuza, the mother of Oba Ewa. Before the Oba returned from Ikoka, Iyasode had carried out his very nefarious plan. And when the Oba got back to Edo, Benin, as it were, saw what happened, and there was only now one person left in the harem, in the entire palace. That's Iden. They were not three. The Oba, the queen, Iden, whom I refer to as the queen for all seasons, Iden Opoku, and the chamberlain who traveled with the Oba to Ikoka.
So is it your mother?
Yes. Traveled with the Oba to Ikoka. So it's just three there. Well, normal. Maybe after some time they will come back. After some time they will come back, because we know ourselves, no one ever quarrels with the Oba and think he will succeed. And that I sack my Oba, I go back here, I go back Takme, I go back Veri, I go back Zegye. The Oba is not a king. Let me just use one word by Amobie Emmanuel Izoduwa. The Oba is not a king. He is a god.
God king.
The Oba is a god, and I've always used the word "is a god king."
Yes.
So it is belittling the title to say the king of Benin, the Oba of Benin, as we say, like I have written in my poetry, Unayati Oba Egwe. Because Oba is wonderful. No one quarrels with the crown and think he will succeed. So it was like, well, they will soon come back. After some time, they didn't. And the things in the palace were depleting. Foodstuff, everything. Of course, you wouldn't expect the Oba to go to the market. You wouldn't expect the queen. Oloyoba, Ayegbekan.
And the Oba cannot go to the farm.
The Oba will not do that. The Oba will not do that. Oba, Onyagbonya, Anamieki Oba. Oba Onyaki. So, after some time, they will come. But this wonderful queen had to beg His Majesty to let her be like a common Benin person, an ordinary person. Remove that cloak from her, that she should go out and do one or two things and see how this problem, what has now become a problem, can be solved. It is the Oba's prerogative to say Oloyi can go out or can come in or can be touched by anybody. It is the prerogative of the Oba and the Oba alone.
What led the Benin people to let the Oba or to let the palace in
Bakio? At that time?
Yeah.
Yes, that was the nefarious plan of Iyase Ode. Who sold to the Benin people that he wouldn't, as the Iyase of Benin, he would be standing on the side of Benin. He wouldn't want the Oba's mother to be buried with human beings. That was what he sold to the people. But innately, his own intention was that if he couldn't have Ide, because Nyagayone, he has paid 70, and the Oba now used his position and clout to take her from him. So that was his grudge. That was his innate grudge.
It was like opposing Oba.
So to placate him, to remove his mind from such thing, he was made the ESA, a Yemami. Because of him, what we now call Akorde, this neighborhood watch, the name of that Akorde, the vigilante thing, came from that name. When Iyasode now planted people to be watching the palace, seeing if anybody will go against what they have all planned to achieve. If anybody will now go and pay homage to the Oba, if anybody will now go and visit the Oba. So those people that were planted as vigilantes now, and were in Akorde, they were watching for Ode. They were watching for Ode, Iyasode, Akorde. That's how that term came about. So vigilantes, neighborhood watch, we now say about Akorde. They were actually watching for Ode. Then, when they have done all this, the queen went out to see a native doctor. The native doctor now came up with a definition that unless a human sacrifice, a human being is sacrificed, the Benin people will not come back. Well, as a mind that moves around, that travels, we'll take that for another day, because whether the human being was sacrificed or not, from what was done, the people still would have come back. But again, it is also said that a senogamio is sagin agabukerine emie. The sacrifice that requires blood, if you give to it gourds of palm oil, it will not work. So that again is another perspective to it. And so after looking out for whom to use for the sacrifice, there was nobody, because the chamberlain, your mother, that followed His Majesty to the Coca had died out of starvation at this time. He had died out of starvation at this time. So there was nobody for several weeks, perhaps months. They tried to look out if it were possible to catch anyone. It was not possible. So she now gave up herself voluntarily. She gave up herself voluntarily. That is why, to me, I consider her as the greatest woman that ever lived on Mother Earth. She cannot be compared with anyone, any woman, whether it's Queen Amina, Queen Moremi, Queen Idia, Mary Magdalene, or Mary herself, anyone, because she did what she did out of pure love.
Then when I was growing up, my parents used to tell us the history of the Zen of Boko. For me, I thought it was just a folk tale. I never believed it was something that happened.
Yeah, it really, really happened. It really, really happened. If she were from the Jesus Christ village and time like that, she would be a Christ. She will be a Christ because she did the ultimate sacrifice. To be able to give the ultimate sacrifice, that is when you attain Christhood. So, to me, as a person, I consider her, she attained Christhood, being the person like no other. She gave up herself, she pleaded with her husband, the Oba, to use her for the sacrifice. And truly, when she was now sacrificed, with the blood on the ground, the oil, the things, the materials on the ground, they started fighting themselves. You betrayed me, you betrayed us, you betrayed them. Why did you do this, why did you do that?
Confusion.
Yes, confusion entered into their camp. And so everybody started running back to Benin. To Benin because a Kenoba ye or Edo. To buttress that, when Iyaso De was chasing everyone out of the palace, and Iden refused to go with them, he left Iden with a message. When your husband comes, tell him that we are leaving Benin for him. That goes to say, wherever the Oba is Benin.
The Queen
then,
she made a proclamation before she sacrificed her life.
She's just a queen, or rather she was just a queen. She couldn't have made a proclamation. Proclamations can only be made by the Oba, and the Oba alone. She pleaded with the Oba that to give her respect. That no matter who the person is, must not be allowed to step on her grave. No matter who the person is, just do that in her honor. And to strengthen it, His Majesty Omonoba Ewakpe, the Oba of Benin, proclaimed at that time. It was not a midnight proclamation. Proclaimed at that time. That whoever stepped on the grave side of Eden, his blood or her blood will be used to sweep and clean the grave side. Not too long after that, it was in the period of Oba Akenbuda, was it? When a man who was given a title for his wonderful work for Benin was given a title. The normal thing, when the Oba bestows a title on a man, he goes on the third day to say, "Thank you, Your Majesty." But while he was dancing to the palace, he mistakenly stepped on the graveside of Ide Oniati Upuna Miami. No baye gewe say or the egwa yak mome on a bowe ye gana semila. Ni e yakye ona yakye I did okie we did de anawe oh ye makwada upuna miami are me well bawe we say u de do kmome unabe ya fiogara. Oh, I know you were near Dide, Tommy Leger. And that was what happened to Upuna Miami. So it lives till today. Nobody should take it for granted that we are in modern day governance, modern democracy, or whatever. Whoever steps on the graveside of Eden, yes. Today the palace may not say Mwere Nagbewa, behead him or do that. But the person will not live beyond 5 days on earth. I, Oba Dolagunyi of Benin, I am saying this and it is true. Anybody that wants to challenge it, what I'm saying now, take one, a member of your family to go and step on the grave side of Eden, it is fenced around now, yes. Properly fenced.
Yeah, so that yeah. People cannot enter.
But if they feel they want to traverse it, you just go. And like I said, 5 days, that is Eden. She should be honored. She should be honored as a woman anywhere. Anywhere, she should be on.
So recently, Imaswe Izoluwa said we should proclaim February 14th, given that it is a lover's day in the West, that we should proclaim that day to recognize her for her astounding sacrifice to the village.
Yes, Imaswe Amuwe Izoluwa, the coordinator. The grand coordinator of the great Benin descendants, Jubilee. Still beautifully, wonderfully well, I must say, the young man. I think my father, HMO Sagi, he has of Benin, was one of the first persons they honored, though posthumously. Because I'm sure at the time my father became an ancestor, Amuwe Emaswe, if he was born, he was still in the primary school, if he had gone to primary school. So, he's doing beautifully well, no doubt about that. And like he has said, what he's doing now is like Iji. It is my prayer that the idea of February 14th as a D-Day will come to reality in his time, in his lifetime.
Yes.
It is my prayer that in his time, he will see that that dream, February 14th, a day then comes to reality. And in Ekiasunu, it must happen.
About to pay.
He said, we're too old.